right there.
One of my favorite ways to fish is with spinning tackle. And it's also one of my favorite ways to get unhooked from my hand. One of my favorite ways to make a video. There's times where I will just grab my spinning rod and spinning reel, tie on a bait, and go down to the river, the bank, or even out on the boat, just simply because it's a lot of fun.
What? What the? What? I just caught a fishing reel. What the?
By far, my favorite is the Shimano Stradic Ci4+ paired up with my MegaBass Levante. You guys know I like to throw a lot of jerk baits on there. MegaBass Vision 110, MegaBass Vision 110 Plus 1. The other main spinning setup that you'll see me use is the third generation Shimano Stradic Ci4+ paired up with the Shimano X-Age. I can fish a wide variety of baits on either setup, but I like to have most of my jerk baits and tubes be on the second generation Stradic, and some of my hard baits or just for fun all-purpose spinning setups be on the X-Age and the third generation Stradic. GoPro, stop recording. What is my favorite line to use on spinning tackle? I like to use Sunline Sniper, and I also like to use Sunline Super in the 8-pound test. Now, a lot of people will tell you that fluorocarbon does not work or does not work well on spinning tackle. False. Sometimes the fluorocarbon will take a while to break in and you might have to use a line conditioner. After a while, after you fish with it enough, I'm pretty positive you're not going to have a problem with it. Now, another thing that I will say is when I use monofilament on a spinning reel, the biggest size I will go is 10-pound test. This Trilene extra smooth casting does work very well on a spinning reel. It casts far and I mean, yeah, it's monofilament. It's going to stretch. It's not going to be super sensitive. It's going to absorb some water, but the Trilene smooth casting monofilament and the Sunline Sniper fluorocarbon along with the Super are two of my favorite lines to use on a spinning reel. Now, is a spinning reel also very good for braid to a fluorocarbon leader for a drop shot or other things? Yes, it is. Like I always say in my reel and tackle videos, you know, there's certain things that work good and don't work as good with both spinning and casting outfits. But another thing that you have to consider is that a lot of fishing, no matter what it is also personal preference. I've said it a lot. I'll probably say it more. The fish don't care what you use. But us as the fishermen have certain things we do and do not like. Now back to the jerkbait. Why do I like to use fluorocarbon with a jerkbait on a spinning reel and a spinning rod? It's personal preference. I've found that I can get a really long cast with a spinning rod and a spinning reel. I like the way it is when I fight a fish. I love using it for smallmouth bass, like I said at the beginning. And yes, once in a while, I will use a casting outfit. Usually 12, 15, 16 pound test, somewhere around there for a jerkbait, depending on where I'm at, the water depth, all that stuff. But spinning tackle is my favorite. I mean, if you really want to know, like one of the main reasons why I do it, it's just plain fun. Another thing that I used to do a lot of that I don't really do that much of anymore, just because I just haven't, is Senko fishing with spinning tackle. Now, most of the time I use fluorocarbon when I'm fishing a Senko. I also like to use monofilament years ago. I mean, like I keep saying, sometimes I'll just grab a rod, a reel, throw on a bait and fish. I mean, are there times where I'm super technique specific and I'm looking at all the numbers and what bait I'm going to use on what reel or what rod? Yes. But there are times where I just want to go out, catch fish and have fun. Senko fishing, whether it is weightless Texas rigged or wacky rigged on spinning tackle, is amazing. One thing that I really like about spinning reels is not all of the time, but most of the time, it does not matter if you are left or right-handed. Usually, you'll have a little, don't drop it. Usually, you'll have a little adjustment knob down here that you can unscrew so you can take the handle and put it on the other side. That's one advantage that a spinning reel is going to have over a bait caster. On a bait caster, you buy a left-hand retrieve or a right-hand retrieve. They're not interchangeable. You can't switch them. And what you buy is what you get. Spinning reel, not the same. One thing that we all like to hear is the sound of your drag. And that is another good thing about a spinning reel is that you can easily tighten or loosen your drag right in the middle of a fight with a fish and usually not have issues with it. Now, once in a while, are you going to go to do it and something will happen or your hand will slip? Well, of course, that's real life. That's fishing. Stuff happens when you go fishing.
What? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? I caught a pair of sunglasses too. All right, what the, what, okay. What is really going on right now?
I tend to follow the lure weight specification that is on the rod. Sometimes I will go a little over or a little under, which probably wouldn't be that big of a deal. But if I have a rod that is rated for 5/8 or 3/4 of an ounce, I'm not going to go take an ounce and a half swim bait or a 2 ounce swim bait and fish it on that rod. The Beetle Spin, Johnson Beetle Spin, that you get at Walmart or that you can find at basically any tackle store, that's a very good bait. It's a very fun bait and it works amazing for panfish and bass. And I've even had pike hit it. A Beetle Spin on a spinning reel, I mean, like, that reminds me of when I was a kid, you know, just fishing from the bank. And like I said, I even still do it now. To my subscribers out there that are brand new to fishing and that don't even know a lot about it at all, always close your bail by hand. It's just not good for the reel to close it with the handle, to take it and crank to close the handle. Don't do that. It's just not good. And it's also going to get you in a good rhythm and a good habit to close the bail by hand. You're gonna appreciate that little piece of advice as time goes on. Trust me. Do me a favor and leave me a comment in the section below. What is your guys' favorite spinning rod and spinning reel? And by the way, when I ask you guys, you know, comment what your favorite whatever is, that's just me interacting with you guys, making the video more social, more fun. Comment below, and I'll see you guys in the comments.
Thank you.